Yo people from Tea, I'm welcome to the David Project Hospital. We are back with the last tutorial of this game. So I think in the next episode we will be able to go to campaign 1. But first we have to learn the rules of hospital management and get acquainted with the hospitalization progress. So let's start. Let's go. Okay, hi boss. With diagnosing and building out of the way, we know that you have one more talent, and that also might need a little refreshment. Let's take a closer look at hospital management. You can start with department management, go ahead and switch to department manager mode. This mode gives you all the information about your selected department, assigned staff and rooms. It also acts as a checklist for making the department work. You can choose who will be the chief doctor. Be careful with the selection, it can have a big effect on the overall productivity of your employees. Ah, so here. Okay. Certainty level is an important setting for diagnostics. It determines how careful the doctors are when selecting a diagnosis, how carefully they look for hidden symptoms. Ah, so medium. Okay. Workspaces consist of a desk, a chair, and a PC, and when built correctly, they will show up in management mode. You hire your employees through them. They show both days and night shift. Okay. So have a look at your hiring options. Click on the empty workspace without the portrait to open up the hiring card. Okay. Let's just go. This. There are four staff categories. Doctors, nurses, technologists and janitors. You can see their experience levels, skills and their requested salary. Also the character perks can make a big difference and are often hidden. If you're not happy with the candidates, a hiring agency will be happy to provide you with a new list of or uncover hidden perks for a fee. Okay. You hire an employee by clicking on their portrait. You can also assign any workplace from the employee card. After hiring an employee, you can see their allowed roles on their workspace. Let's have a closer look at your staff. Open any of your employees' card. Click either on occupied workspace in management mode or click on an employee in game mode. Every employee has a few different statistics, their level, skill and specializations. For technologists and nurses there are 3 experience levels, for doctors 5. Different specializations get available as the employees level up. So this is going to get real complex later on, I would assume. Skills are fixed for each type of personnel, but get improved by being used. You can learn more about individual skills in tooltips. Specialization gives the opportunity to work at certain departments or rooms and allow the employee to perform specific examinations or treatments. Doctors can have 1 or 2 specializations. The first one allows basic work at a certain department and is available for all residents. Level 2, the second one is usually related to surgery or diagnostics, available for fellows. Level 4. Employee roles give you the options to control what task each employee is allowed to perform. This way you can also make sure that you have staff available when they are really needed, for example for surgery. Let's take a quick look at management tools for the whole hospital. Open hospital management card by clicking on it on the categories on the main panel. Where? Oh, there. This card contains 5 categories. Department statistics, insurance, ambulances, budget and statistics. Check them often because they will give you feedback of what you need for running an efficient hospital. Okay, now onto the different parts. Our hospital needs a functional hospitalization progress at the general surgery department. Switch to department management and select general surgery department. Check what rooms are missing at general surgery department and build them. Remember that rooms with red numbers next to them are mandatory. Tooltips for rooms on the list provide some extra information. Okay, so we need a HDU. So I guess we can use that for that. Mm. Yes. Let's just get this one. Okay. Filibrator. It'd also be nice. I guess we need a table or something, or cabinet. I don't know. Or this, maybe. It's time to hire a surgeon for the day shift in the on-call room. You hover over the profession tooltips will advise you when which specialization is required. Can be filtered in okay. Oh, oops. Just hide somebody that I didn't need to. Maybe here? So we need a surgeon. Ah, okay. I just hired two wrong ones. Now that we have working hospitalization, the ambulance will bring us our first patient. This should be only a minute. There's a hospital already. Ambulance. There it is. Let's pause the game so you can select the patient easily and take the patient under your care. Now let us follow the patient through our hospitalization process. This can start at the emergency department with observation or trauma hospitalization. For observation, when there is no clear diagnosis and the patient could have one or more dangerous symptoms. The diagnosis is clear. Patients get treated and sent home or hospitalized at the specialized department. Patient goes to an observation room. Following cave. Okay. Trauma center is an essential unit for handling different types of traumas and accidents and most critical cases that your ambulances bring to the hospital arrive here. Same way as the observation room, as long as the diagnosis is not clear, the patient will be examined here. Okay. Physical. So the current symptoms are two hidden: hypovolemic shock, open wound, abdominal injury, and blood loss. So first, physical. Active treatments, emergency care, and TC hospitalization. So we will speed it up a little bit. Procedures have finished. Okay. Patient is waiting for you to plan another examination or select a diagnosis. Okay, so we have something. Yeah, severe hemorrhage. Okay. Let's go for Dick's next. Let's just check. Patient can't talk. Well, she has a trauma, so probably not. Not a good thing to have. Just gonna do them all. A spleen rupture, okay. Available treatment. So you have every symptom. Not available, not available, not available, not available. So I guess we have just two? Yeah. Let's just click on the both. Yeah, because the blood transfusion will take care of the blood loss. Ah, clear diagnosis the patient gets hospitalized at specialized departments. Okay. Regular ward is suitable for a patient without any risk of life-threatening conditions. High dependency unit is suitable for patients in risk of collapse or life-threatening conditions. They are generally equipped with life monitors to keep an eye on the vital functions on the... Okay. To be connected to life support and to get continuous care. Intensive care unit is not only a hospitalization type, but also a standalone department. Switch to department. They're all surgery department, so we need to go for this one. Wait for a patient to be transported to the room. So it's only the spleen rupture that is now the problem. Where did she go? Did she go in the elevator or something? I'm supposed to work around the clock and there are few important times in the daily schedule. Oh, she's in this room. I didn't even notice. Treat your patients. Suppress all high hazard symptoms. And now we can do them. Hopefully you have covered all the... Okay, I got attending achievements. Okay. Well, that was the tutorial. The last one. So, in the next one, I will go and doing the campaign one. Which will be, will you manage to lead this hospital out of debt? That will be a difficult one, I guess, because I'm not sure how this game works still. Well, technically I did the tutorials, but I'm not sure if I will be able to manage the hospital. But we will see that in the next episode, so please don't forget to give us a like and to subscribe. And I will see you next video. Bye!